undercover, gotta stay on this mission. Got a vision that's endless. They told me don't be a menace. They gon' serve me a sentence. But now I'm up in the illest. I'm just minding my business. If I'm grinding, I'm shining. Don't got time for the gimmicks. I'm it.
Squad.
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 This being modest, I am your highness. I am the finest. You rappers, plus you a liar. Don't idolize and I don't admire. Been doing me for like ever. I'm a better me, more clever. It's a new way. We surfing, baby, new ways. That's a certain, baby. Let's take a ride, let's take a ride. Put your for the ones that die. It's fast tonight. Just you and I get lost tonight and lose your mind.
Squad,
I'm it.
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 Squad.
To the float out, you already know though. It's Adamville for real, you see ya, just take a photo. I'm reppin' as on photo with a on your brodo. Cause that dodo thought that he could rob a player for some dodo. Oh no, also Allen Temple, also England Manor, also Misty Valley. And I got a couple yesterday out of Cali. Am I bad from the valley? Bought me brand new Balance. And I'm playing with a no American dream. Man, she been riding since her daddy rode on four. I done in every hole, telling every hang with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go.
Big flap, rip flap, flash it. Don't I look dashy? Don't I look classy? Don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. That's with or without you. With what your say, show me what that.
I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. Hey, don't you see me out here shining, better flex. I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. And even if we die today, gon' live forever. You live forever.
three S's. The S's, no S's on my chest, but all these diamonds got me blessed. Usually I don't do this, dumb it down, go stupid. Since 17, been counting M's, my bank account's on goofy. Gave up. Now who know what the truth is? What? Chicago full of, my garage is full of hoop. This got that southern drawl and all that. My like ball bass. The South got something to say, and all y'all can't get y'all ball back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call sacks? Daddy fat, y'all never ball back. Like clocks in the wintertime, we stay eating like it's dinner time. Been feasting and feasting and feasting big, but it ain't no rhyme. We don't know the meaning of drought, cause we keep it so wet, why swear not? It's been a while. Just speaking in general, why there is no formidable opponent or at that bone that you never step on it. When you wanna mind the kind of give it hope when they down and out. Dig a hole so deep, ain't no climbing out.
Yeah, I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. Don't you see me out here shining, better flex. I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. And even if we die today, don't live forever. Live forever.
Yo, listen, just like I told Coco, my.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned in to Madden 18 on EA Sports.
In today's game, we should look to the war up front. The Buccaneers are top 10 in rushing yards, and they're going up against the Panthers team that will need to keep the running game in check.
All right, Larry, we are at a site that's played host to two Super Bowls, and that's Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. Here's Winston. K'Wan Short in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Jameis to throw it. And the pressure gets to him again.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
And this will be taken at the 13. Flexing his muscle at the 30. A terrific return there. 27 yards all told. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. Here on 1st down. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They will run again with Coleman. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets them a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Now Newton on first down. Steps away to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. Buying time to his left. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. A shotgun snap for Newton. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And Gano's kick is right through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. Well, it's a night game, a lot of energy in this building, but the visiting team here, they get the ball in the opening drive, and they find a way to at least produce 3.
And things are just getting started, so you can't say that they've taken the momentum totally, but a good start towards seizing it in this game.
And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Throwing again, Winston on 2nd and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete.
It looks like, yes, it is. 6 defensive backs on the field for Carolina.
They're going with a dime set. From the shotgun, it's Winston. This is caught by Jackson. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. The handoff goes to Gordon, running left. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
On 2nd down, they'll run with Gordon. Gordon loses the football. It's It's loose. And the Panthers have recovered. Partner, on my spot sheets, I highlighted turnover margin because we remember they turned it over four times last week. So another one here in the first quarter. This isn't the way they want to go.
No, not even close. And it's not something they even imagine because the amount of time that we know that they spend in practice talking about what they need to get done, working on it, showing them how to take care of the football, and emphasizing what it means in terms of winning, they got to just be puzzled right now that they're not taking care of the ball better.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
To throw on second down is Newton. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Now a play fake, and it's Newton. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Robert Ayers, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. With it is Jackson, shifts by him. Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. On second down, Winston again. Dancing to his left. He finds some open field here. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. For a big guy, Jameis sure can move. Did a nice job there picking up the first down with his legs. Now Gordon on first down. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Jameis on second down. Going underneath for Gordon. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now the first carry for Doug Martin. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. That one 28 yards on the ground.
We can talk about bend but don't break all we want, but the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them?
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it, and he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Week after week, we're seeing plays like this from him. And I think he's in line. We've discussed it before for NFL Defensive Player of the Year.
And a big reason why, I think, is because of his ball skills. And that's something that, for guys of his position, they've talked about it for years. They've done the drills. But it really increased it in recent seasons because of the offense have gotten so good. He knows how to take the ball away. That is huge for a defender.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number 2. They've got it 2nd and 4 to start things out. Shift together here from the D-line. On 2nd down, here's Newton. Taking a shot for Samuel. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
On 3rd down. That's Coleman, and he will have 1st down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath, they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up 1st downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Robert Ayers, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Coleman, and he'll work this one up to about the 38. That'll get a little bit back, give him 5 on the run, and they'll be left with a 3rd and 13.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
The Panthers on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Out of the gun, Newton. Taking a shot for Samuel. And that's caught inside the 30. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
Well, he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now 3rd down.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let them down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff them for a loss. The Panthers on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. From the gun, here's Newton. Throw incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And Gano's kick is right through, and that will add 3 more to their lead. It pushes it up to 6. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
First down, Winston. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And, oh, he'll be shoved to the turf that time. Give him 3 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put in.
Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time, and it's third down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On third down, Winston. And this is going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And they split the uprights last time for... They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Stay on the ground. Again, it's Coleman. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. They fake the give. Newton. And this is caught. It's Greg Olsen. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Here's Newton now on second down. And this one complete right side to Funchess. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Off play action, Newton. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this down deep into Tampa Bay territory. Give him 30 yards there. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Newton to throw. Being chased out left. And avoids the contact by sliding. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. The Panthers on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This time it's 3rd and 3. This is Coleman, and running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. And the Buccaneers go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And Gano's kick is right through. And that will make our score 9-0. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
Not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though this offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. A 2nd down throw for Winston. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them. But a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you...
And he loses the football a 2nd time. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around. And we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. On 1st down, it's Newton. And this is caught inside the 5. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Here's Coleman, hammering for the goal line. He loses the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Throwing is Newton. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Greg Olsen, as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and... Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
On first and 10, Winston. Jackson's got it over the middle. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. Down throw for Winston. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Following the penalty, here's Gordon. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. So we come upon halftime, intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. As we will toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, is that you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
So the defense gets to the quarterback. Now the offense backed up on second down. Play action. It's Newton. All the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Gerald McCoy in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Operating from the gun, Newton, flushed out right. Now he's going to send this one deep. He's got a man, complete. And they finally are able to take him down at the opposite 47. A big third down play there for the Panthers. And even 40 yards. On first down, Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. And it's caught over the middle, Wilson. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
To throw on second down, Newton. Flush. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. The shotgun snap for Newton. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. So make him 4 out of 4 now in the field goal department, and he's able to extend their lead.
When drives have bogged down, he's been automatic out there. So nice to have a kicker you can count on to put points on the board.
This will be fielded at the 8. And shedding through the tackle. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Throwing again, Winston on 2nd and 10. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up 3rd down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that fell harmlessly to the ground. Winston. And running with power here. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. It'll be a gain of 16 and give him a 1st down as well.
Are we really in the second half here? And this is the first time we've seen Jameis Winston connect with Mike Evans?
Yeah, you know that they missed that in the first half. Up until this point, they've really missed it, haven't they?
I think that's a big reason why they're down on the scoreboard right now.
Throw right side, taken in by Godwin. And he's brought down. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Fresh set of downs here. From the pistol, they run with Gordon. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Left side here, that's complete to Godwin. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. So the offense has it 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Winston. Fighting through. Eluding the pressure right. And I think the ball's out. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually. And they'll hold on to the football as well.
Now I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule. Where the offensive player fumbles the ball, goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're... And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Melvin Gordon with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Bucs are able to cut into that deficit. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Panthers coming out now. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. Newton now to throw. Got his target, Samuel. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They convert on third with a gain of 22.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
So second and medium, second and five now. From the gun, Newton. He's got Wilson, middle of the field. Touchdown, Carolina! Albert Wilson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Winston now to throw on first down. He sets to fire deep. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
I'm not sure, Brandon, we've seen a sloppier played game this year for a team on offense. Turn it over 4 times and expect to win? No chance whatsoever. And look, I have no idea what the ratio is about turnover 4 times and how that correlates to winning or losing. But I'll guarantee you, it's not very good.
Well, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Give him 30 yards there. They go play action here on first down. The swing pass caught, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Adam Humphries, his first touchdown on the year. And the interception by the Bucs D leads to a touchdown. And he puts it through. Back now in Tampa. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So here we go, first and 10 now. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Now a play fake, and it's Newton. He's going to go deep for Funchess. But he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Pressure too much. Down he goes. Kendall Beckwith in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he gets this away. And look at this. This is a good one. Here's Jackson. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and 1.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs. Now the offense lining up, first and 10. From the gun, Winston. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
Looking deep downfield. And oh, Jameis intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 28, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. So now he's equal to his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this. But he is in a major league rut right now. Let's see if his teammates can pick him up along the way.
You're right. He talked about being cool, calm, collective, rebounding. Not rebounding right here. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. They fake the give. Newton. Airing it out for Olsen. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. A big play there for Carolina. 52 yards. A much better effort we're seeing from him under center this week versus last week when he threw four picks.
He has thrown the one in this game, but you're right. When you cut it down from four the previous week, and we always talk about adjustments, well, he made some in practice. And he continues to work on it during the game. I'm sure he's getting plenty of reminders about how to stay in the moment, stay focused on the task.
And he's got him in the driver's seat here in the fourth quarter. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push him back more. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Tevin Coleman, his 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And that one makes this a 19-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Bucs now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Well, this has just been obviously a dreadful day for him throwing the football. Now four interceptions. This one leads to 6 points going the other direction. Tough.
Yeah, it is, and this feels old school to me because you never really took out your starting quarterback back in the good old days. No matter what was going on, he was your guy, and you rode him for better or for worse. In today's football, usually we've got a backup who's warmed up and is coming to the game, so you can see an old school approach here that's not really benefiting him at this point.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And they gave up the pick six. And now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Luke Kuechly in there to sack him for a loss of six. Now Jameis on second down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And now it's third down.
Well, he leads the NFL in interceptions and nearly added to that total.
Got his hand on it, couldn't quite corral it. It's been a Pro Bowl-type season for him, and the term ball hawk really comes into play, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that one a lot because teams want to avoid that type of a player, but sometimes you just can't. He just knows where the ball is.
And now another one thrown incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And it's fielded at the 34. Might might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Now on first down, he's going to sneak it. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Far be it for me to second guess a call. I think the people in the stadium are probably doing the same thing. Did we just see a first and 10 quarterback sneak?
For no gain. For a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Oh, a quarterback sneak on second down. And a short gain here, down to the 22. A sneak good for two, but it's still going to set up a third down.
Hey, give him credit. That's a good solid game there on the sneak because it all comes together. Enough space, get forward, gain yardage. Well done.
The Panthers on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This is third and 8. They'll toss it to Coleman. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Wasn't able to get anything, no gain. Fumbled once already. Maybe he's being a little careful. Not necessarily on that play, but I'm sure that's in his mind somewhere.
Oh, without a doubt, because protecting the football is job one for anyone who's carrying it, and that's exactly what he tried to do on that play, but it didn't gain him any yardage.
Now off goes Newton, and on comes the kicker, Graham Gano. It's a 39-yard attempt, right hash. But no cigar, just wide right. And this score will stay right where it is. So he's not perfect after all. He made his first four, but now his first miss.
Well, you shouldn't have to put your kicker in a spot where he has to even try five field goals. He's bailed him out time and time again, but sooner or later, he just had to know his luck was going to run out.
They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, took a little more time off the clock, making him do it that way, didn't it?
And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable third and three. At the beginning of the year, they said, we want to win 9 games. They just got that 9th win.
And congratulations to them. That's fantastic. Team goal met, and they still have opportunity to go above that number.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we bid you good night from Tampa.